We have new details and some exclusive video from that shooting turned police chase. Plus, you may not believe what sparked the violence. That's our big story tonight at 11. Three people were shot, two arrested, but not before leading police on a chase in and out of Baltimore City.
Today, new information about the victims, the suspects, and what led to those shootings. 11 News reporter George Lettuce has more tonight from police headquarters. George.
Well, Marianne, late tonight we got that exclusive surveillance video from a convenience store near the shooting. An employee at the store, Dale Brown, was manning the register Wednesday night in the Dundalk neighborhood where, as you said, three people were shot. Two of the victims were teenage boys ages 14 and 15. Let's take you to that video. It was moments later. One of those boys with a gunshot wound to his leg is carried into the store to get help. With blood running down his left leg, the boy sits on a chair as Dale Brown calls 911 and instructs the boy's friends to apply pressure to the wound. Now, Brown knew what he was doing. He was a combat medic in the military. He kept everyone calm and made sure the boy didn't lose too much blood. Brown says the boy was in shock but seemed to handle the whole situation better than expected.
Actually, yeah. He was a lot stronger than I thought, you know, a 15-year-old kid would be, you know, so, yeah. But, God bless that everything is okay.
Now, EMTs arrived about 15 minutes later, put the boy on a stretcher, and rushed him to the hospital. Police tell us all three victims in this case are expected to be okay. Wow. So, meantime, late today, police arrested the alleged shooters in this case, 33-year-old Charles Robinson and 31-year-old Quincy Alford. Police say the whole incident, this whole shooting, stemmed from a fight earlier in the day amongst students at Dundalk Middle School. At this point, it's not clear how a 31-year-old and a 33-year-old got involved in this. We're live in Baltimore County. George Lattice, WBAL-TV 11 News.